Hello, so in this video we're going to be looking at integration. Now integration is the opposite of differentiation, or we can think of it as the opposite of differentiation. Now first of all we need to remember how to differentiate, and if you're a little bit rusty please go to one of my videos on differentiation just to remind yourself. But basically what we do, especially when we have y equals x to a given power, we take the power, we multiply by the power, so we get 2 times 3 will give me this 6, and we take 1 from the power, so 3 take away 1 gives me 2. So when we integrate, we're going to undo what we've done, so we're going to do the opposite. So what we have to do is go backwards. So we start with the last thing we did, so we took 1 from the power, so the first thing we need to do is add 1 back to the power. So 2 plus 1, adding 1 back to the power, gives me 3. And then what did we do before that? We multiplied by the power, and to undo a multiplication we divide. So we need to divide by the adjusted power, because we multiplied by this original power up here, and so we have to make sure that when we undo that we need to divide by this power there. So we have to divide by our adjusted power. So we divide by this 3, and 6 divided by 3 gives us 2. So we can see that this, in this case, this approach works. But there is a problem. So let's have a look at the next slide. So this time we're going to differentiate this. And you need to remember, when you differentiate a constant, you get 0. So again, that's in my other slide. But if you just consider a constant, say y equals 4, we can see that the gradient of that line is 0, and when we differentiate, we're getting the gradient, and so the gradient is 0. So y equals 2x cubed will give us the 6x squared as before, and then we actually, when we differentiate that 4, we get a plus 0. So now we take this, we've got dy by dx equals 6x squared. And we're going to now, that's our answer, we're going to do the opposite, we're going to integrate. So we do what we did before. So we're going to add 1 to the power, which is the opposite of taking 1 from the power. So that gives us a 3. And then we're going to divide by the adjusted power, because that's the same as multiplying by the original power. 6 divided by 3 will give you 2. But there's a problem, we've lost this 4. And if we're just given this function here, how do we know there was ever a 4 there? How do we know that what was there? Well, we don't. And so basically, if there's a constant in the original function, plus 3, plus 2, plus 1, you can't tell. And so what we have to do in order to cover ourselves, just in case there was something, we write the constant of integration, which is c. So when we integrate a function, we always have to add a plus c, because we don't know. We don't know whether there was a constant which has been lost in our original function. It's very important, so you really must remember that. Now, before we go on, I just want a quick reminder on differentiating x to the power of 1, just because sometimes it confuses people. And then when we integrate it, we have to be sure what we're doing. So if we have y equals 4x, we can say that's the same as y equals 4x to the power of 1. And so we do what we normally do. We multiply by the power, so we multiply by the 1. We take 1 from 1, gives us 0. Anything to the power of 0 is 1. So we've got 1 times 4 times 1 is 4. So when we integrate, we want to go backwards. So we start with dy by dx equals our 4, and we think of this as 4 times x to the 0, because remember we had this x to the 0 up here? And anything to the power of 0 is 1, so this is the same, this is 4 times 1. So we add 1 to the power, 0 plus 1 gives me 1, and then we divide by our adjusted power, there we go. 4 over 1 gives us 4, so we get 4x, and we mustn't forget, although it seems to be forgotten here, to add the c. So if we have our differentiated function is a constant, dy by dx equals a, some number, the answer is y equals a times x plus the c. So whenever you just see a number, when you differentiate, when you integrate it, you become, it becomes ax plus c. Okay, so give these questions a quick go. When you can pause your slide, and when you're ready, you can start again. Okay, so here's the answers. So we just use the rule. Now, when we integrate, we remember we add 1 to the power. Now, this power actually is x to the 1. So 1 plus 1 is 2. We then divide by our adjusted power. And then we remember to add our c. So here, we take our power. We add 1 to our power to give us the 3. We divide by our adjusted power, and we add c. And we have 3 over 3 gives us 1, so we get x cubed plus c. Okay, here, when you have more than one term, we just go term by term. So we add 1 to our power, so 5 becomes 6. We then divide by our adjusted power, so 5 becomes 5 over 6, x to the 6, power of 6. And then we look at this one, and we were just talking about it before. If we differentiate, if we integrate a differentiation function, which is a constant, we get the constant times x. And then you add your plus c. So remember, to integrate, you add 1 back to the power, and then you divide by the adjusted power. So the power you get once you've added 1 back to it. Now, at the end of this video, I just want to go into using the integration sign, or introduce the integration sign. So if we wish to say we want to integrate a function, we use this. Some people call it an S. There we go. The integration sign. So if we wish to integrate some function, so we've got x to the n, and we say with respect to x, because when you go further on in your maths, you might have other things you might want to integrate with respect to. We can write it like here. So here's the integration sign, which says, please integrate this function with respect to x. And all the rules are the same as they were before. So what we did, we added 1. When we integrated, we added 1 to the power. We divided by the adjusted power. And then we remembered to add the constant of integration. And this is called the indefinite integral, as it includes the constant of integration. There's an unknown in it, so it's not. Later on, we will talk about the definite integral, but this is the indefinite integral because there's an element of an unknown in it. Okay, so give these questions a go. Again, you can pause the video and then carry on when you're ready. Okay, so do term by term. So we add 1 to the power, gives me cubed, and then we divide by the new power. And then we add, integrate minus 1. Again, when we integrate a constant, we have that constant times x. So this becomes minus x. And then we add our constant of integration. So here, this is the little 1 there. So 1 plus 1 is 2. And then we divide by our adjusted power, divide by our 2. And so 2 over 2 will become 1. And then again, when we have a constant to integrate, it just becomes the constant times x. So that becomes minus 3x. And then we remember to do the plus c. And here's just a little bit sorted. Here we have the constant. And when we have a constant and we integrate it, we just get the constant times x. So 1 times x is x. Now here we're doing exactly the same. Don't be worried because it's a fraction. We've just got a half. And then we're going to add 1 to a half. Adding 1 to a half gives me 3 over 2, and then we're going to divide by 3 over 2. Now, when you divide by 3 over 2, it's actually the same as multiplying by 2/3. If you're not sure about that, you probably need to just go back. But if I've got 1 over 2/3, that's the same as 3 over 2. We can lift that bottom 3 up to the top. And then we add our constant. And then this one's just a little bit more sorted out. Okay, I hope that was helpful. Have a good day.